In today's Daily Dish, EA Sports details improvements to modes in NBA Live 15. A poll has gone up about your experience with NBA 2K15 thus far. An update to the Extra Life charity drive. The NBA 2K15 app is available for iOS now, and the latest Press Row podcast has gone out. It's just 2 weeks until NBA Live 15 releases, only 10 days for it to be out on Xbox One via EA Access, and yet the company still seems somewhat afraid to show the game off. At least now they've detailed the work they've done on modes. While there are no new modes this year unless you count the tutorial and practice drills, and nothing dramatic for those modes that carry over, each one has received some level of improvement. EA is talking up the online experience and giving the struggles of the competition that makes sense. Ironically, though, NBA Live 14 was pretty awful online, but EA does have a track record to support the claims otherwise, so we'll see. Head-to-head seasons and seven-game series are what's offered outside of just the standard one-off online games, plus Ultimate Team, of course. Rising Star Career Mode was bare bones and uninspired last year, and that doesn't look to have changed, though create-a-player grading and progression have received upgrades. EA also made it clear a few months ago that Dynasty Mode wasn't a priority, but they didn't leave it untouched, having worked on free agent and trade logic and sim stats and adding a new simulation option. I think it was probably a mistake not to offer something innovative for NBA Live 15. There's nothing terribly compelling about the product as it is, and they clearly don't seem to be confident in the gameplay given they don't want people to see it in action. There's still some time to change that and give people a reason to think this is a viable $60 product, but the days are quickly ticking away and word of mouth may fall completely on that EA Access trial. I know some don't like the concept of EA Access, but at the very least it allows for information and impressions to be disseminated on games such as this that the company is actively shielding. I posted a poll today on PastaPadre.com. You can find the link in the YouTube description or Daily Dish posting on the site in an attempt to gauge the experience of those with NBA 2K15 a little better. I've discussed at length the server issues and struggles with things like face scanning, and certainly social media shows that there are many having trouble with the game, but still, this can be another data point to consider. There's a lot good about NBA 2K15 also. How has your experience been with NBA 2K15? Vote in the poll there, let me know in the comments or on Twitter at PastaPadre, and I'll discuss the results on a Daily Dish episode later this week. The My NBA 2K15 app has made it to iOS. Last week, it was available just on Android. The app lets you earn bonus VC daily, use a chat function on your phone or tablet while in My Park, and includes a separate My Team card battle game. It's a worthwhile download for those who own NBA 2K15, even if it's just for the daily VC. I've dropped a link in the YouTube description and the Daily Dish posting on the site. Last week, TJ Lowerman joined me on a Daily Dish episode to talk about the Extra Life charity, an upcoming streaming campaign on October 25th to raise more funds. He now has detailed some prizes that will be available in a raffle for those who donate. There's some cool stuff in there, including an Xbox One copy of Madden NFL 15 signed by Richard Sherman and Cam Newton, Colin Kaepernick, and Richard Sherman jerseys. Head over to thatsportsgamer.com/extralife to provide your support, and in doing so, have a chance to win a prize. The latest Press Row podcast went out on Friday. It features panel discussion on early NBA 2K15 impressions. That includes the good, like the gameplay, presentation, and level of content, and the bad, such as the servers and the face scanning. Check it out by subscribing to the Press Row podcast on iTunes or the Stitcher app on Android, and I've dropped a link in the YouTube description and the Daily Dish posting on the site. Make sure to visit PastaPadre.com, which is updated every day with the latest sports gaming news and analysis. Follow me on Twitter at PastaPadre and subscribe on YouTube. I'll be back tomorrow with the next Daily Dish.